101.5. He's going to be at the State Theater on New Year's Eve. We got him on the line right now. Southside Johnny Lyons, the pride of Ocean Grove, New Jersey. How are you, pal?
I think I'm the bane of Ocean Grove.
I was trying to give you a little credit there. That's what they say, you know.
Okay, for sure. I'll take it.
So how the hell are you? You haven't been here in a while.
I'm good. I'm glad I'm not on the turnpike or the parkway. It sounds pretty bad. I'm sitting in my little chair in my little house, and I'm perfectly happy to be here.
You're working it out for New Year's Eve?
Yes, I've got a few surprises in store as far as songs are concerned. You know, you never know what's going to happen on New Year's. That's why it's New Year's.
You never know what's going to happen at a Southside Johnny concert. You know, you're a renaissance man when it comes to music. You like to go everywhere and try everything. You know, your music is so widespread, and then you bring it all together for a great show.
Well, we try to, you know, and fortunately for me, I've got the musicians that can handle all that. This is a really great band now, and they're capable of hitting every curveball. So if I want to pull out a polka or some jazz thing or just craziness, you know, improvisational stuff, they're more than happy to jump in and push me off the stage and take over, which is a good thing, believe me.
I was lucky enough to be on stage with you and Bon Jovi back in 95. We were sitting at the bar. Remember down at the Tweeter Center at the time, Governor Whitman was in the audience.
Right, I remember.
It was amazing just watching you guys work and you know, just how in sync that band is. And it just gets better with age.
Yeah, you know, it's just, it comes with the territory of being a juke. You really have to be on your toes, pay attention. And I think all these musicians love that. They've all had other gigs where it's, you know, you same show night after night. And it can be wearing on somebody who really wants to play. If you're just in it for the money and just want to go through the motions, great. But if you really want to get out there and play and find the heart of the night and go off in on tangents, then this is the band for you. I love it that way because I don't get bored.
Mm-hmm.
It challenges me, too. And the audience knows what we're doing. They know that when we're going off the reservation, they kind of go, uh-oh, there they go. And, you know, if we make it, they go, yay. And if we don't make it, they go, and then we go right, I don't want to go home, and this everything's okay.
It's always good to have that. Always good to have that tool in the box. You played with so many different bands. I mean, is there's got to be such a great comfort level with you with the Jukes, like you said, because they know exactly what you do. You're a great quarterback up there. You know when you know they know how to pick up your signal and take it wherever you want to go, and you to follow them.
Yeah, they know too that they can start something and will go in. I mean, if somebody yells out something and I'm not quite sure what they said, Jeff will start playing something, or Glenn or one of the horn players will start playing a riff, and we'll go into a riff and we'll make up a song on the spot. So, you know, it's really just having fun and making music on stage. It's we're not trying to convince anybody of anything other than to have a good time, and we're trying to have that too. So it really works with the audience. You know, the audience is there to have fun. We're there to have fun. It's nobody's trying to get over on anybody, and that's always what I wanted in a band, and I've had it for a long, long time. I'm very blessed that way.
I'm talking to Southside Johnny Lyons. Southside Johnny and the Asbury Jukes. Big show on New Year's Eve at the State Theater. You can go to statetheaternj.org. You talk about just having a good time, not trying to change anybody's views or anything. It's all about the fun. Greatest Southside Johnny concert you've ever played. What was the one that you remember you just had the most fun at?
So many of them, you know. I mean, well, speaking of New Year's, it was the New Year's a million years ago when we were playing the Capitol Theater in Passaic, and Bruce and the East Street Band showed up, and Bruce came out and played the song with us, and he said, I got some new stuff I want to play. Is it okay? I said, yeah, you can do whatever you wanted to. So we went to New Year's. We did about an hour and a half, maybe two, and then Jim and his band took on the stage, and they did another hour and some. It was one of those wild nights, and we all started to improvise, and those are the kind of nights you remember, because nothing that is planned, it's not like anything is really planned, and yet it all falls into place. And, you really cherish those moments.
You know, there should have been an album released that night. You and Bruce, I once asked you why you guys don't play together, and you said because it would be about a 12-hour show. Nobody would leave the stage. I got to ask you, because, you know, you're one of the great coverers of music. Joe Cocker died yesterday.
Yep.
Your thoughts on Joe Cocker?
Well, I did the Hope concert last night at the Count Basie Theater, which we are not playing this year. I should say the State Theater in New Brunswick.
Mm-hmm.
But we did the Hope concert, which Bobby Bandiera set up, I guess, 7 or 8 years ago. And, of course, John was there, John Bon Jovi, and he did the letter, and I did with a little help from my friends. And
wow.
Joe Cocker was a big influence on all of us with his freedom.
Mm-hmm.
And he was so wrapped up in the music when he was singing that it was just, we all wanted to get lost like that in the songs. And he was one of those guys that pointed the way.
Absolutely. Johnny, we're going to give away a pair of tickets to the show. We've got second row seats. I want you to pick out a number from 1 to 10, and that's going to be the caller that's going to win the tickets. Johnny, what number caller should call and win these tickets?
3.5.
Come on, Johnny.
86.
I'll give you one more shot. Between 1 and, thinking of a number, between 1 and 10.
Let's go with Lucky 7.
All right, Lucky 7. Johnny, thanks so much for coming on.
Hi, thanks, Steve.
You got it, pal. We'll see you on New Year's Eve on New Jersey 101.5. You want to get your tickets for Southside Johnny at the State Theater. It's going to be statetheaternj.org. It's going to be a great show. And